Minister Humphreys, I was looking through your first references from the last time, 4 years ago, and the tallies for this year. Now, there's four boxes missing. When I was looking at the two figures, they were almost identical. Now, at a time when the party's figures are going down, it must be very heartening to have maintained almost your exact same goal.
Well, it is very heartening. It's also very humbling. I'm very pleased and very grateful to the people of the Cabinet Monitor who have put their trust in me once again, because that's what they're doing. They're trusting me to represent them on their behalf, and I've always committed to working hard, doing my best for the two candidates.
And I was talking to Joe Riley earlier on, and I said, you know, looking at those figures again, the figures and the tallies, it seems to be there was an error made. If you look at the two cabinet candidates, if they had combined those votes together, you might be looking at the situation whereby they'd be in the convention for the last week, and yet it doesn't look to be the case the way the numbers are panning at the moment.
Well, the way the numbers are looking, we're not quite sure, but you just never know when it comes to transfers. This has been a different election, and many would say that. So you really don't know until the final count is in. I'd love to see DP coming and joining me in Dollar, but we just have to wait and see how it all pans out later, probably tomorrow before we have the final results. Mm-hmm.
Now, another thing was looking down to the fight for the last seat. If it was a case that, you know, with Brenda Smith and Niamh Smith fighting it out, if Niamh got it, you'd be looking at three female candidates in return for the constituency, which would be quite unique.
Yes, indeed. It looks like Pauline's going to take the second seat, that would be myself, Pauline, and possibly Niamh would be three. Niamh and I have obviously been in situ for the past 4 years. And that's what I want to see, is more women get involved in politics, and that's important. And of course, Sandra McIntyre was our candidate in West Cavan, and she has performed well. She's a new person, completely new to politics, and again, we have to get more women involved. I'd love to see a 50-50.
But just in terms of that, you know, Sandra was a good candidate. Everybody said she worked very hard, but the numbers don't stack up. If there had been one candidate, maybe from Cavan, maybe it would be a different story. Was it a strategic error, do you think?
Well, of course, we have the strategists in the party. I was very clear that my canvas area was Monaghan and Cootill, which of course is my hometown, and that's where I did my canvassing, and that's where my campaign was focused. And the county of Cavan then, the chamber of Cavan, and indeed Northley was assigned to So, again, you never know.
And one of us has been in government for quite a while now at this stage. Do you think that was one of the things that played against you?
Yeah, well, Fine Gael have been in government now for 9 years, and we have been very prudent with our budgets. And, you know, when Fianna Fáil was looking for their third term, again, it was a giveaway budget which got them re-elected. We did not do that, because that's not the right thing to do for the country. We had a very prudent budget. We've shown a surplus of 1.6 billion, I think it was, last year, and also projecting a surplus of 3 billion next year. And that's to protect this country against the shocks of Brexit, because Brexit is not gone away. It's certainly very much on the horizon, and it will make a difference. It will change the way we do things with the UK. And I know we got a good deal in terms of the withdrawal agreement. Free trade agreement starts now, and it's going to be complex, it's going to be difficult, and whatever comes out of it, it's still going to be good. You know, it's never going to be good for this country.
Now, we're looking at a situation whereby you have two constituencies that may be returning, no Fianna Fáil and Fine Gael TDs. I mean, that's quite shocking.
Well, I'm not aware of that yet. I haven't heard, I've been so busy looking, obviously, in my own constituency. I haven't had a chance to update myself on what's happening around the country. But what I would say is that only a week ago, all the pundits were saying there was a meltdown coming again. This has been a meltdown. And in fact, we have recovered somewhat in the last few days. And I think that people do realise that change costs money. And if you don't have a performing economy, you can't drive change. And I think that that's people started to realise that, and I think that has meant that we have come back a lot. You know, we were, as I said, we were going to be a meltdown, but but we have managed to come in now at somewhere in the mid to late 30s or possibly even 40s. Again, there's going to be a lot to pay for here in terms of transfers, eliminations. You know yourself, you never know until the final count is declared.
Finally, in any situation where a party drops seats, people will be looking to the leader and they'll be saying, is he the right person for the job? What would your answer to that be?
Well, I'm very happy with the leader that we have. I think Leo Bradford has done a really good job. I think when it comes to the TV debates, he was able to turn this around. He performed extremely well, and he has my absolute full support.
Thank you.